Hey guys, how's it going? My name's Billy's and welcome back to Regrowth. I almost said Crash Landing. I just recorded that. This is Regrowth though. Last time, we started getting ready to set up for robots because I forgot to make Terra Steel. And you know what? The End of Flames, while they are not too bad, they're terrible. They're not bad. They're good for how expensive they are. But we're going to look into some better mana production in the near future. Maybe this episode, maybe not. But I do have the piece of Terra Steel. So we can go ahead and start doing... we can try the Gaia Guardian fight. Now, I don't know how prepared I am for it. We'll see. I do have enchanted armor. It's halfway decent. It's got a lot of protection 4 on it, so it should be good. I should be good health-wise. But we're going to kind of guarantee that. I have 2 death protection poppets, and we're going to bind them to ourselves. And yeah, hopefully we don't die. So we have extra health. We made that last episode. We made a few extra red heart canisters. And yeah, I want to just kind of jump right into this. We have our witherproof wand. We have some jeweled apples, a magical potion. I'm going to carry this sword on me just in case. I'm not going to carry the manual and pick. So, how long does this... It's all 25 minutes, so let's go ahead and take that. Wow. We have insane... This is insanity. So, if we shift right click, we get the Gaia Guardian. We can't go past that, it'll knock us out. We can't fly, even if we did have flight. But, the biggest thing is we're gonna want to, try to kill him. Also, the Gaia Guardian. Oh, I have to turn the music down just a little bit. I don't know what it is. Let's just turn the music down completely. The Gaia Guardian does take your skin. He's going down below. Unfortunately, that is a thing you can do. But, we are not getting withered. Not really. And our sword is doing actually really well against him. And, our armor is sending out pixies to attack him. We have range. Normally bows don't work against him. That is a thing. If I had flight, we would not be able to fly. Ooh, let's eat a jeweled apple. And I think he's underneath. And he's getting close. Here soon. He's down below. I really need to fix that. I don't know how to, though. I don't know what the best way to do that would be. But, he does teleport a lot. Hopefully we don't have to kill the Gaia Guardian 2 all that much. He's a lot worse to deal with. But this is the second phase. So this is going to be where my manual and stuff comes in handy. Basically, he's just going to summon a whole bunch of mobs. This is a nice little break. Let's just not let the mobs overpower us. Unfortunately, where he's at is terrible for this. This would be a good time to have the crossbow or something. He will summon some wither skeletons. This is no problem. I can take care of them. And looks like we might have some treasure or something. Yeah, there he goes underneath. And just attacking him. We're not getting knocked back because of our tectonic girdle or whatever it's called. That's it. We beat the Gaia Guardian. We didn't die. our armor is actually doing pretty well, and yeah, that went a lot better than I could have hoped. We got a mysterious map number 2. We already had one of those. We also got a torn page, which is cool. So let's get our inventories back together. This wand was super important for that. The sword actually did pretty good. We could always improve it though, so let's take a look. We just completed Guardians of Earth. So that was killing the Wither, killing the Gaia Guardian. We're going to get 4 more Gaia Spirits and a Greenheart Canister. And now the part I've been waiting for a while. So we have 12 Gaia Spirits. Now, here's the thing about the Gaia Spirits. They are very useful, yes. But they are also... the reason they're so useful... And also, we should actually put down the poppet shelf. We'll put it down right here for right now. That will chunk load the area, which is not an issue. I'm the only one that plays on here, so... And it's not a... It's an internal server, not an external server. So who cares? But we will put these poppets on the poppet shelf, and those will let us, those will still be used if we die, so no dying. Let's clean out our inventory a little bit. We have some bows, we have a bunch of rotten flesh and zombie brains now, which is really nice. The torn page and all that kind of stuff we should put back, but whatever. So... Let's go ahead and get some of this stuff back in our inventory. Get something normal, sorta. Can we scan the Gaia Spirits? No. Nope. Alright, so I'm gonna put that in there. I think we already did 2. I think... let's just look through our quests. So we have 3 new quests. So round 2, yep. We're gonna have to do this. Basically, this is a powered-up version. This requires Gaia Spirit Ingot is a piece of Terra still wrapped with the Gaia Spirits. So, there it is. Just a piece of Terra still with 4 Gaia Spirits. That is round 2. That is much more difficult, but it's not terrible. So we'll get that someday in the near future, probably, but not today. That's gonna give us some wills, potentially, which we can put on Terra Steel armor, joining the Ivy League. So this is, I actually don't know what Timeless Ivy does. Nope, that's not the Lexipitania. So let's see, Ender Artifacts, Resolute Ivy, that is not what it needs to be, the Gaia Spirits is what we're going to need to use, So, Timeless Ivy, there we go. Mana Steel or Elementium tools have the ability to harness mana. Okay, so Timeless Ivy allows virtually any item to be repaired with mana. So that's kind of cool. But it requires... Yeah, it requires a Gaia Spirit. We're going to make that just to make it. We're going to get 3 more. And then we'll also need this. This is what I want. The Fugal Tiara, this thing is what I've been waiting for a long time, and I can't spell it. Fugal, no, Tiara, let's just spell Tiara, Flugel. So it requires 4 Gaia Spirits, Ender Air, 2 Feathers, 2 Elementium. We can handle that. Now, here's the thing though, I don't want to use all my Gaia Guardian Spirits. Otherwise I'd have to do that fight again, which isn't bad. It's a halfway decent way to farm that, but I don't want to do it more than I have to. So let's get to... So we're going to keep two of the spirits probably down here. We have two elementium. That's good. We'll keep four spirits right there. We are going to get more into... Is that done? Huh. I think we can probably set up robots. Yep, I have the MLOR gates. We can set up robots. We're not going to do that today. Just because I'm not quite ready. But where you're going to need the Ender Air. And... That is in here. We need... I think that's it. Yeah, so we just gotta go find a crafting table. So there's one right here. And we can go ahead and make the Fugal Tiara. So, Ender Air, and then Gaia Spirits. So the Fugal Tiara is amazing. We're gonna claim that because, oh yes, that has mana in it. So we're gonna put that on, and we're gonna put that on. And now we can fly. For a limited time, it would seem, but we can fly. And it's creative mode flight. That is going to make my life so much easier. It's better flight than Thaumcraft was. So, we have four more Gaia Spirits. We also need to make the Ivy League stuff, so the Timeless Ivy. So, let's go ahead and make that. Might as well. We're going to need Vines, Gaia Spirit, and the last Elementium that I have. But we're going to look into getting more mana. Probably today, actually. So, I just need to get some Ivy. And Nature Spirits are going to be the best way to do that. Not Nature Spirits, Nature Essence, which is right here. I think it's 7. I could be wrong on this. I think it's something like this. Yep, there we go. So, Vine, Gaia Spirit, Elementium, Timeless Ivy. We'll get three more. And, yeah, so we're pretty much done with the Batania stuff. There's still a bit more to do. We're going to need a lot more. I'm going to want to get a lot more stuff from Batania. But for the most part, we don't have to worry about it. So, let's see, what other quests are available now? So, we need to do round two. We'll do that another time. There's two quests here. Mysterious map number two. I'm just going to keep that because it's completed. No counting, so Observations of Immortal and all of those. We'll get to those later. That's for being a vampire and that kind of stuff. Let's see what the world embraces. There's nothing there. Encoding the world. There's something here. Oh, yeah, the hives. We might be able to do that here soon, actually. Life of the World. We still have a seed to get, but it's going to require wispy cotton. We're not quite ready to do that. And then more eggs to produce. That's what our mana is going to be used for more than anything. And I'm trying to think of what the Gaia Guardian might have unlocked. How the World Bleeds. How the World Enhances. So we're going to need to get back into Imagecraft, or Academycraft, relatively soon. But I think for now, something I want to do is look into making Gormyrillus. Gormyrillus, that's what it's called. So we're going to need some Runes of Summer and Fire to make these. And I want to make extras. So we're going to need melon, slime, and sand. That is not difficult at all. So 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's take just a bunch of melon. I'm going to take like a stack of carrots and a stack of potatoes. I'm going to cook the potatoes. And let's see, we need sand. So I think it's like so. Nope, I always get those mixed up. So there's a bunch of sand. We're going to need some slime. That is not too bad to do. So if we look at the slime, we'll get a stack or so of that. And what else do we need? We need to get Runes of Fire. We make a couple of those Should be too bad. So, nether brick, gunpowder, nether wart. Most of that's pretty easy. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Gunpowder, nether brick. We're gonna need. What's the easiest way to get nether brick? And smelting netherrack. And we can make that really easily. Like so. Alright, so let's put that back in there. Let's grab some coal. And we will go ahead and start cooking up some netherrack as well. What else do we need for it? Let's actually look up the runes. So rune of fire. Rune of summer. So these are the two that we need. So mana steel, gunpowder, and the mana powder, which I'm not seeing any in there, so we're gonna have to get some more. That's fine. Let's get a block of iron for mana steel. We're gonna need a lot of living rock. We don't have that much, though. So we're not gonna be able to do too much of this right now, and a lot of this is gonna be off-camera anyway. What we can do is we can take 16 of these. And if I can do this, we'll make the white floral powder, and that's what we'll throw into the system to be dealt with. So baked potatoes, we'll need those soon. Let's go ahead and just take some nether bricks. We are going to need, we're gonna need more runes of fire. Let's just take all the runes with us. And yeah, go from there. So the Gormorillus, these functional flowers are much better than anything else that we have so far. So we're gonna need rune fire, so we're gonna need to throw some of that in there. We're gonna want to get a mana spreader. Let's just take this one back off. Yes. Oh yeah, I can just break it. And take the mana spreader. We could upgrade these as well. Put it there. Bind it to that. Give it this lens, make things better, and we should be able to do this, and I forgot to grab gunpowder, which we might have some over here. No. But we have a whole bunch of nether wart, so that's good to know. Do we have any in here? No. Okay, so we have to go back. Oh, dang it. So basically, I want to make these flowers, these functional flowers, in order to get more mana. Oh yeah, we have plenty of gunpowder. So I'm gonna do like two sets of the runes, or something like that, and we're gonna take the summer. I have the summer. We need. What color flowers? So we need light gray, yellow, and red. And then the only thing is we need to find our mystical flower thing. And I have some seeds right here. Is it down here still? It is. So what colors are this? Two yellow, two light gray, and a red? Yes. So we'll just pop all of that stuff in here. So Q, Q, Q. And then the rune of summer. And we'll come back for the rune of fire. And we need to eat, make sure we keep eating. We can fly over here. We can put this here. Smack it. And we'll do it again. Right click with an empty hand. That's the last recipe. And then you can actually, this is something I learned later, you can actually just right click and it'll put the living rock onto the thing. But we come down here, we throw in the rune of fire, and that, and we get the generating flower, the food flower. So we're gonna take these baked potatoes, and I don't know how quickly it will consume these. I know that it doesn't consume them immediately. Like, I know that it takes time. But there's those. So to get summer, we need earth and air. So earth and air. Earth, air, melon, slime ball, two sand. So this is gonna run out of mana pretty soon. We put this guy right here. He's connected to that, and we put a single baked potato. It'll eat it, and it produces a decent amount of mana. Like, it filled up this guy, and that was just from one baked potato, so I don't know how quickly. But yeah, it's gonna create a lot of mana, and that is exactly what I want, so we'll make a couple more. Melon, two sand, slime ball. That on there. The other thing is I can still use carrots. Carrots are actually really good. And I'm trying to think. There's a catch. I know that there's a catch. But we have two summers. I want to keep one summer, and I'm going to go ahead and throw these coal here, that is pretty much what I wanted to do. So that's going to give us a lot more mana, much quicker. So do I still have, yes. So if we can find some seeds, I would not be surprised if there's some in here. Trying to think where's going to be the best place to get seeds. Seeds right here. Okay. That's the only thing that I'm going to have to remember is I need to keep a stockpile of seeds as I go places. But let's grab some water. And we'll head downstairs. We'll make another Gorgomilus. And I want to see if there is a catch. I know that there is. There's got to be. But we need to find our Book of Britannia. The Lexicon of Britannia. There we go. So we just come here. Drop. 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 So I believe the Lexicon of Britannia is up here. And let's read up on the Gorgomilus. Generating flora. Yeah, this guy. So it'll eat up in a small area and turn into mana. There's a catch though. It can only set. Ah, that's what it is. They can only digest a single food item at a given time. The mana is created when it's done. Any other food it finds, it also devours, but it will not create any mana from it. So carrots take 2 seconds to digest. So what I can do is take this. We will go back over here. That's why I didn't generate all that much. But if we put this like right here, make sure that it's, yep, it sees this mana spreader. And we'll just throw a carrot to it. Make sure both of them have carrots. And you can see just how much more mana it's creating. And then it's done. And so all I have to do is kind of time this. Make a redstone circuit or something so that it just drops food every 2 seconds. And it's going to generate just a lot of mana for me. So I'll have to look into like how to automate these guys a little bit better. But that is going to be the plan going forward. So for now, I think I want to go ahead and call the episode here. We did a lot today, actually. But I think what I want to do is I want to see kind of what's next. So I don't really care about those. We're going to want this metal former. We also need to deal with the think tank so that we can get back into Thaumcraft and all that fun stuff. But we'll do that another time. I need to get to the witchery seeds. I need to start growing more mandrakes for one of them. That is kind of the key for some of those infusions. But so let's see what the metal former takes. Requires a bunch of these. Oh god, that's nasty. Machine frame, empty unit. That's actually not too bad. And then a bunch of the constrained metal. So it's just these calculation chips that are a bit of a pain. And it's a lot of metal. So I will, since I've already made a bunch of those, I think I'm going to make those off camera. And then next time, I think we could do that. And then what's this? Data terminal. This is getting into more academy craft and actual, like, brainwave analyzer. So more calculation chips, data chips, information process, more chips. Is there an easy way to make these? No. Nope, not at all. So yeah, before we get into that, we're gonna want to automate more stuff. So maybe we won't do that. Let's see what else we have. Blood magic. I want to set up blood magic before we do that. Witchery needs to be moved before we can do too much with that. I need to find things that are going to unlock other things. That's probably going to be the best thing. Maybe next time we will do a little bit with bees. I think that would be good. Now that we have flight, we can start going around and if I go to the right chest, it's over here. We can start catching bees and kind of go from there. So I think that's going to be the plan. And yeah, that should be fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I know we didn't do all that much, but we're going to be getting into a lot of stuff very soon. We finally beat the Gaia Guardian. That was the important thing. So I think next time we're going to do bees for the most part, and then we might look into some more spawn eggs. We might also get into hobgoblins. These guys are going to be kind of important later for witchery stuff. But otherwise, yeah, I think we're going to go ahead and end the episode off here. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!